I'm NetMoverSitan, and welcome to my first underground minecart line. It has taken much gold for me to make this. As I need the gold for the powered ring. Along with the coal to smelt it. Of course, I could make charcoal, but I only do that when I'm low on coal. I intend to make more of these underground train lines once I find more gold. But for now, I have other plans. And yes, I know the inventory is a bit sparse. But that will be explained. I am returning to the Nether to better explore the Nether Fortress. And this time, I will come prepared. But before I go to the Nether, I have something to show you. Something which will greatly improve my survival chances. Do you want to know what it is? Well, keep watching to find out. Because I will be going to the Nether for the purpose of making this bigger. That floating island is where the research tower will be built. I've already made a start on it. Yes, a start on it. I'm going to make it entirely of Nether brick blocks. I will need netherrack in order to do that, along with glowstone. The blocks need to be put in those places. And as you can see, I have a fully functioning enchanting table. And here, in this bricked basement, is where the brewing will be. Once I get around to making the equipment for it. Don't know what I'm going to do with this floor, but I'll think of something. Depends on how big I can make this tower. Now to do enchanting. Oh yes, I almost forgot. I am going to make a cake. Let's see. A more durable helmet. I will need some lapis lazuli for that. Ooh. I'm guessing that makes it so that I can stay in water for longer. Forms. I'm guessing if I get hit, they take damage as well. Ah, and added protection. Even better. Now for my trousers. Fire protection. Definitely. And it's more durable. It doesn't break as easily. Now for my sword. Sharpness, definitely. That means more damage. And I'll certainly need it where I'm going. Now to enchant my diamond pickaxe. Ah. Yeah. It uses experience. I can go with that. Oh yes. I want to enchant the diamond shovel. No, it won't break as quickly. Right. No, that doesn't work. Oh yeah, and I have this theory that iron golems will be more effective down there. A little more expensive in resources, but they'll probably be much more worth it. Yeah, the water bucket won't be as useful in the Nether. Three wheat, two sugar on either side, one egg, and three buckets of milk gathered from cows. Not in this case. Oh yeah, and the buckets can be reused. Just remember to clean them afterwards. Right, best get rid of what I don't need. Before heading into the Nether to explore farther the Nether Fortress and see if I have really locked down the monster spawners. I'm not sure. I know how it works with the standard variety of monster, but blazes, they can fly. Well, with the added fire protection, they shouldn't be as much of a problem as they once were. Still have an oxygen bar. At some point I'll guess I can't have my cake and eat it as well. Right, let's see what this diamond pickaxe can do. I need to make some stone ones to gather netherrack. My diamond pickaxe is enchanted. This is too valuable to waste. Best not stay here too long. As when there's rain, monsters don't burn up. Well, the undead ones don't. Yeah, 9 golem in case things are worse than I thought. Let's see how they do. Probably a bit better than the snow golems. They need to be on snow for them to be of any use. To the Nether, where hopefully I won't die this time around. Oh yeah, might as well bring some obsidian in case I want to make a Nether gate in the Nether and see where it takes me. If it is in an unfamiliar place. Then I can easily go back. Although I'd best make sure that the Nether Gate is in a relatively secure place. I wouldn't want to be ambushed. I must remember the way correctly. Oh yes. And as for making Nether brick blocks, that is gained by putting Netherrack in a hot furnace, turning it into bricks, and then making it into brick blocks by arranging them in a square formation. A 2x2 square, to be more precise. Much like with making bricks out of clay. Although, with the clay bricks, they do not stay alight when you set a fire. Yeah, might as well gather some Nether Quartz while I'm here. I have a long-term plan regarding that. I have many plans that I shall reveal later. Right now, I have a Nether Fortress to assault. Hopefully a bit better than last time. You remember what happened last time? I went into the caverns. After that. And got a bit lost, making it a two-parter. I promise you, if it looks like it's going to get a bit too long, as in, can't be bothered to make the journey back, I'll cut it off and inform you of what happened. Ah, soul sand. That has a unique prophecy here in the Nether. I shall show you what it does. It slows you down. And what I'm going to do is gather it. Because it might be useful. Yes, it might be useful later. As I believe this is needed to grow Nether Wart. Something which might have some unique properties and just need to I know that they are not mushrooms. Yes. An endless sea of lava. There's no water here. Unless it is what you take with you. I won't be able to get back up, and even if I had enough health, I'd be deeply vulnerable to anything that would threaten me. Gonna have to build it up if I want to gather that. Ah yes. Something which gave me so much trouble last time. Ah. I need to bridge the gap. Gap is bridged. Wither skeleton. To create a wither. Ah, the blazes are out already. There must be another monster spawner nearby. Thankfully, I have come prepared with many snowballs, and I have a better shovel to make them more. Snowball fight in winter in countries where it actually snows. It's just a bit of harmless fun. A snowball fight here against blazes is a different story altogether. Yes, there's definitely one there. one that needs to be removed. I will need to gather nether rack in order to create a bridge. What are you doing there? Yes, feast on snowballs. I was hoping to gather some blaze rods while I'm here. Not ready for that yet. Yeah, lock down this corridor. I don't want to go here until I am ready. I have blazes to take care of. I don't need the added distraction of. Wither skeleton. I need to replenish my ammo. Don't expect me to make bad puns intentionally. If you wanted that, either watch Undertale, go play Undertale yourself. I'd recommend doing that before watching. Or watch pretty much anything involving Chuggercon. Thanks. I'm surprised that he hasn't played it. Perhaps he doesn't want the competition. Oh yes, blazes. Thankfully I have additional fire protection. And look, a blaze rod! Prevent that wither skeleton from Whoa. Is that strong against Neverack? At least I don't have to worry about them going from this way. Ah. Although they can sneak up. Just have to make sure that they don't get close to me. Yeah, Neverack is cheaper to gather. And is readily available, so why wouldn't I use it to make a bridge? Although, it could be a problem, considering that with the skeletons in the way. Could knock me down. Yes! A couple good strikes and they go down like any other skeleton. don't need their stone swords. I have something better. Diamond sword. With added sharpness. Thanks to the power of enchanting. They also drop coal. Although, I'd much rather have a skull. Three are needed to make a wither, a boss that can be created. Although it is best to make sure that you're in a safe location. Would you rather fight it where you are prepared for it, or not? Yeah, not my plan at all. What can you expect? My pickaxe is stronger than I thought. Best do it quickly. Same with this one. Walk off all excess ones. Let's make sure that it's fallen down here. At least that's the general idea. What's the idea? So is it stronger? There no substitute for some nice nobles to counter their fireballs, although to put something at the top I'll need to go with. I don't know how good this fire protection is. I'm in a safe earth. I might as well rearm myself against lasers in a cheaply acquired, readily available resource. Snowballs. Resistance seems to work. Well, that's good. Looks like my best option is to go directly. I can afford to take a few more risks. Now that I can resist their attacks effectively. Although that doesn't mean I can't get damaged by fire if I stand it. It just means that I can withstand this better than I once did. Although it also helps that I have diamond armor. Can't seem to figure out if I can jump over that. Good for me. That makes killing them, although they're technically dead to begin with, much easier. Now to make the iron golem. Oh yes, and make sure I can regenerate health. Right. It requires 4 blocks of iron with a pumpkin on the top. Now I have a powerful and durable warrior to aid me in locking down these monster spawners. I'll let the monster spawner get locked down. That should hopefully be that. No, that's a mushroom, not Nether Wart. What? Ah, wither skeletons. Best keep killing them. In numbers, they might overwhelm me. Now they haven't. Slow process locking down the gone. Where did they come from? Clearly I have not been thorough enough. I need to completely bury these monster spawns in order to stop them from spawning again. At least that's the theory. It appears that it is not enough to simply surround it on all sides with blocks. Ah, good. The zombie pigmen don't appear to be bothered by snakes. Ah yes, the wither status. Best let it pass by. Well, you were partially successful. At best. It'll take more than that to kill me. Now. Best you could do. Well, it's not good enough. Oh, they're coming from there as well. Yeah, let's see if my theory is correct. I need to more deeply surround them. Monster spawners that creates. And what is down here? I have no idea. All I know is this is where this road ends. And I'd rather not continue exploring until I'm sure that all of the monster spawners have been disabled. I'm going to have to make pretty large rooms to contain them. Of course, I have planned for. Oh yes, of course, the staircase. Mm-hmm. so it is true. They need to be more deeply contained. So that spawning him will be much more difficult, if not impossible. They just keep coming! Yeah, I need to completely fill this in. Oh, I can gather more nether bricks. Well, netherrack to make nether bricks. No! Yes, feast on my diamond sword. Please tell me that's locked them down. Right, now I'm gonna have to do the same with the other one. That'll mean much fewer lasers will spawn in. Never interrupt me when I'm keeping more from you from coming. This will make it much harder for you than it should be. Ah, more netherrack. Hey! Did I say you could spawn in? No, I didn't. Right, I'm running low on snowballs. Ah, right in front of me. Perhaps it needs to be a certain layer for it to make spawning in impossible. It's obviously what you've done well enough. I need to be thorough when I want to contain. Let's see what's up here then. Oh yeah. To be able to generate health. Ah! A magma slime. Let's kill a few of these now. Give me a break from the blazes. At least they're much less mobile. And decent sword practice, which I clearly need. This could be a good place to put the Nether Gate. be some hollowed out places that allow them to spawn in and drift away into more open areas. I'm gonna have to block those off as well. Block off anywhere that could be used as a spawning point. Unless, of course, there's more than one monster spawner. I need to think more three-dimensionally. Well, it looks like at least this monster I just can't win with you, can I? Yeah. Feast on that. Come on. How long are you gonna keep this up for? Bury us completely in blocks if I have to. So that's where this one is. Hopefully. Dare burn me. Seriously, what do I have to do to stop you from spawning? You know what? I'll figure that out later. I don't want this to be another two-parter. Unless, of course, you want me to make this a two-parter. In which case, let me know when you want the two-parter and what you want it to involve. Yeah, they last long, don't they? I'll see if I can lock down them at all. I'll let you know how that goes. As well as the progress on the research tower. Until next time, hail the rabbit!